79-year-old Cyril Kalipa clearly remembers the day the Don Isidro was bombed by the Japanese.
They were spotted over at Cape Fauquier, west of Bathurst, and there they were bombed. It was about 9 o'clock that morning, and we could hear the bombs from there. It was clear, beautiful day.
11 men died when the blockade runner's captain and crew abandoned the burning ship and swam for the shore. But a number of relics were salvaged from the wreck, among them the ship's bell, which is now used by a community church on Melville Island. Of all the ships bombed on the 19th of February 1942, the Don Isidro is the only wreck not under government protection.
In 2017, the Don Isidro will automatically be protected under the Commonwealth Historic Shipwrecks Act, and the bell itself will then also become protected as a relic.
But Cyril Kalipa wants the wreck to be listed sooner to protect what's become an important part of community life.
Oh, it's got to be there. It'll be there for life. That's our bell.
I think it's really important that the bell has some sort of protection. I think it's important that it stays safe. It's a really important historic relic. But it wouldn't be my decision as to whether to instigate heritage listing.
The Territory's Heritage Branch is investigating the matter to see what steps it can take to have the wreck and its relics protected. Melanie Arnost, ABC News, Melville Island.